Here's how to play the Rosetta Stone Polyrhythm. Okay, so I'll start with 1 minute of music theory. If you just want to learn the groove by ear, feel free to skip that.
This groove is basically the Swiss Army triplet, flam, right, left, played as straight 16th notes, not as a triplet, which gives us a 3-note grouping that obviously does not fit into a 4-4 time signature, as you can see here. So we rather need a 3/4 time signature or a 6/4 time signature to make this work. But in our case, since Danny plays a 5/4 pattern with his feet, we'll write this down as a 6/4 groove to make this whole thing work. So I'll just go ahead and copy and paste this foot pattern here over the hand pattern. And as you can see, we need 5 bars of 6/4 time signature until hands and feet fall into one again, which makes this groove actually very challenging.
All right, so let's have a closer look at the hand pattern.
Okay, so we have the Swiss Army triplet, which is flam, right, left. And at least according to this video of Danny playing Rosetta Stone, here's how this rudiment is applied to the hollow horn kit. So he basically moves back and forth between 3 of his toms or pads or whatsoever with his right hand, playing doubles, which in this case translate to the flam on the right of the flam right-left pattern, like this. The left hand playing the flam and the left of the Swiss on the triplet obviously stays on one pad, I believe. At least that's how I transcribed it. However, Danny plays an accent on his snare with his left hand at the end of every 4th Swiss on the triplet, which falls in line with every 3rd coordinate. That sounds actually more complex than it is. If you move back and forth with your right hand, you'll notice that the snare accent always happens at the very same position of the right hand. In my case, whenever I reach the lowest tom with my right hand, I know I have to finish the rudiment with the snare.
Okay, now let's move on to see what the feet are doing. The foot pattern itself is nothing too special, except that it's in 5/4, which, once we play this against the 6/4 time signature, gets very, very complex, actually. It took me almost a week of practicing to get comfortable with the kick drum, because it really works against your brain. So once you feel ready to start practicing the whole groove, I recommend to start with one pad only before moving around the whole kit. Okay, so I hope this was helpful. Thank you for watching. And here's the whole beat played at 70 and 90 BPM and finally at full speed. There's also a link to the sheet music we have in the comments. Have fun.